Hey, Curtis. Yeah, if the Bengals win and no one's there to see it, does it actually count as a win? The answer, of course it does. A win is a win. But yeah, after a second consecutive blackout from local television, the effects are being felt both downtown and beyond. The area surrounding Paul Brown Stadium is typically a hot spot before Bengals games. But this season, downtown is a ghost town.
When you have more people down here, it's awesome. I found a place to park right outside the door.
Crowds are even more sparse at surrounding tailgates.
This is as bad as it's been in a while. Normally it's double parked. You can't drive through here.
So where are all the fans? Mike Hurley is taking the stay-at-home approach.
The food prices are next to nil, okay? And the beer, you put a quarter in the machine, it gives you a dime back and an ice cold beer. I mean, you can't ask for no more than that.
And whether the Bengals are on TV or not, Mike says he and his man cave contingent are finished investing in the organization, both financially and emotionally.
Most people really don't care as much. You know, they're tired of it. You know, it's a bad system.
And good luck getting any of these guys down to Paul Brown Stadium for a game anytime soon.
They don't want to go down there and spend money on the tickets, the beer, the food.
Had season tickets, gave them up 3 years ago. I like a good party, and Mike Brown wasn't coming through, so I'd come here. It's fun.
Of course, ultimately, winning trumps all.
Give us a competitive team. We'll all be back on chip.
Well, Curtis, they looked plenty competitive today, and a lot of those fans that stayed home are probably kicking themselves now after the Bengals edged out the Bills 23-20. Reporting live downtown, Adam Clements, News 5.